What's up guys, this is SB Architect. Today we are going to be modeling Tornado Tower in ARCHICAD. But here, the most important thing is we are not going to use any add-on like Grasshopper and any other softwares. But before we get started, I would like to ask you to like this tutorial, because it's going to help to growing this channel up, and I suggest you to subscribe so you won't miss any of my tutorials. Alright, let's get into this amazing Tornado Tower. First thing I'm going to do is, I'm just going to go to Options menu, Project Preferences and Working Units. Click this millimeter to centimeter and click OK. For the mass, we need some help from the Shell tool. Let's go to Shell tool. And for the Geometry method, I'm just going to click this, and Construction method, click Revolve. Now we are at the sketching state. We're gonna draw our facade on the floor plan, like this. When you're drawing in ARCHICAD, you can see these options. These are going to help you when sketching. I'm gonna click this one. Click here, and click this. It's gonna continue from tangent, and make a smooth curve. We are going to complete this shape like this. Once we have that, we are going to make an axis. And input here 360 degrees. Click OK. Once we've done that, we can make some adjustments. You just click the shell, and click the corner, and fix their positions. I want to make a curve without any corner. If you click this corner and click this one, make your drawing at 90 degrees. Just make the same for this curve as well. Once you have done that, you will have a perfect curve. Alright, let's go to 3D. You will see this mass in horizontally. Let's just rotate this at 90 degrees. You just press Ctrl plus E, hold click this corner, and change the rotating axis like this. After that, input 90 degrees. Click flip. Go to elevations. Because we are going to make small adjustments. In the elevation, you can make this precisely. Let's just drag this one to here. And extend this section window to see the whole shape. Once you're satisfied, you can go on for modeling. Okay, let's go to floor plan. Now, we are going to make some reference planes. I'm gonna use Morph tool for this. Let's just make a rectangle like this. And go to 3D screen. As you can see, there is 3 meters space between Morph and Shell. I'm gonna input here 0 and OK. OK, both are at the ground floor. Ctrl plus U, click this Elevate. And click OK. After that, you just click a reference corner and input 300 and drag your mouse to the top of the mass and click again. I'm going to control top of the mass and the last morph we just created. Let's go to elevation. You can see the gaps here in this window easily. Let's just fix them like this. Okay, I cannot see any more problem. Once we have this, we are going to go to floor plan, copy this morph, go to 3D, rotate this morph, Ctrl plus E, click this corner, hold click, change your axis, click second corner, input 90 degree, and extend this edge to the top of the mass. Maybe you can extend a bit more, and click this morph to the center of the mass. Once we have done that, we are going to copy this one from the center of the mass. Ctrl plus E and input 90 degrees. Select this one again and rotate copy this 45 degrees. And select others. And rotate again to the half of the edges. There we go. We have this interesting shape and we're going to click this morph. Ctrl plus A, right click, connect and solid element operations. Click this get target elements. You just click the shell, get operator elements, click the subtraction and intersection and execute. There we go. I think we have done the hardest part, but we have much to do. Let's go to Beam tool and click this profile. You can choose any profile type you want. For the structural element, I'm going to use steel structural, so it doesn't matter at this stage. I'm gonna use this for visualization and click the center point and click like this. But we have a problem. We're gonna click this one and make again. Click here, here, and we're gonna climb this tower around like this. But you can click the intersection points easily because we're going to make some more for this and we have some intersection points. You will see this intersection icon, a black dot. When you see this black dot, you can easily click that intersection points. There we go. As you can see, we have done this all around the mesh. You just click any of the beam. All of the beams are going to be selected like this, because they were grouped automatically. In addition to that, you can just hit Ctrl plus G for grouping. Click this icon twice, so you will select all of the beams. Ctrl plus U. Click rotate. Click this first one. Click rotate to path. And go OK. Click the center point. After that, you just click the starting corner, click the second and complete the shape at 360 degrees. But you not click the first starting point. There we go. We are going to mirror this one. Go to floor plan. Select them all. And also this one. After that, you input your mirror command and click the center of the mesh. Let's go to 3D. I'm going to use F3. Here you can see ArchiCAD is processing. There we go. We have done this without any add-on, Grasshopper and any other programs. You can select the beams, change their profile sizes. For the demonstration purpose, I'm gonna input 10 cm. Also, you can use any different profile types. Or, you can just change their profile axis. I'm going to change this mesh to the glass material. But before that, I'm going to change the structure. There is a surface shortcut here. Okay, here we go. Click this override surface. Click this chain. And click the glass. Let's just click this mesh and change their thickness. For example, 3 cm. But here some parts are inside of this mesh. To fix that problem, we should have done our levels 150 cm, not 300 cm. Maybe we can change reference axis like this. It didn't work. Maybe we can offset the axis. From here, this input 10 cm. But as you can see, the problem wasn't fixed. Let's go to elevation and click the mesh. If I click this, okay, there we go. If we just offset this edge inside of this part, maybe we can fix this problem. There we go. But again, I suggest you to make your levels 150 cm height. For the demonstration purpose, I just leave this one like this. Let's just get rid of all of the morphs, select them all and click layer, click the hidden. Maybe we can use these morphs from other models. Alright, we have done the facade, but we don't have floor slabs. There are different methods to make that. One of them is using Boolean operations, other one is using subtraction in the shell tool. Another one is offsetting the edges. We're going to offset the edges. I think it is the most practical way. But before that, we are going to change floor visibility of the shell. Click OK. Let's go to Slab tool. Click the Structure Type to Simple. And press the Spacebar key to around here. But it must select all of the circle, but it won't work. Let's just make a circle and fill the inside with the slab, with spacebar, and just drag this slab inside of the shell. I'm just hover over the edge of the shell and I can see center of the shell clearly. Ctrl plus key, resize and click OK. Click the center. Reference start and reference end. There we go. This was the first floor. Let's just click the first slab. Ctrl plus U. Elevate. And click the set home story by elevation. Click OK. Click reference point. You just input your 3 cm height. Drag your mouse and click the tab of the mesh. Once we have done that, we can select the slabs and offset inside. I am very sorry about that, but we are going to make this one by one. If you don't want to make this one by one, you can free to use Grasshopper add-on for ARCHICAD. I'm going to make fast forward this for you. There we go. This was the last slab. Now you know how to do this. You can add more details for your projects. But I think that's all it for me. I'm not going to extend this too much. If you like this tutorial, please give me a like and do not forget to subscribe. If you have any question or suggestion, please leave a comment below. And if you want to download this one or any other my tutorial files, you can just go to my Patreon page. I leave a link in the description. Also, there are Patreon only tutorials. Take care, see you at the next one.